The first match of the evening is going to be between the Mighty Morphin Power Drones and the Four Horsemen and the Associates.
Felt it. It was grainy.
Four Horsemen are going to be on blue. Mighty Morphin Power Drones are going to be on gold.
It's being salty to the lawyer team.
That's fine.
That's fine.
That's fine.
That's acceptable.
Yeah.
That's
acceptable.
I just assumed he was saying
he's
with the guy taking a shit?
Who is it?
Hey,
Hey, are you taking a shit out of your ass? Can I not hear?
No, you're fine. All right, so on the blue team we have looks like Jamal as a sub tonight, I believe, right? Jamal's a sub.
Yes.
Phil, double L Phil. Brian as their queen.
Dan
and then Andrew on the back there. And then on gold, wrapping around, we have Hannah and
I think his name's Eric.
Oh, Eric, okay. And then the queen of this team is Leah, and then Adriana on, is that abs on that
gold
side?
Gold stripes.
And then,
no, she's abs.
Anita on gold.
Anita's on stripes.
On stripes, yeah. Anita on stripes.
And you are Chris?
I am Chris, yes. Hello.
I'm Richard. Peace.
Wait, we'll get these games started.
Let's do it! Let's get ready to bumble! Start the set!
Do it! This makes you want to like hiking. The music here is pretty rocking tonight.
Oh man, I haven't played anything. Someone's playing some good jams.
Yeah,
they're playing like some Black Sabbath.
I like when they play good music, as in I don't have to spend money.
Exactly.
It's expensive.
Oh, yeah.
It's like $1 a play. I mean, you gotta skip all the garbage.
Yeah.
You got a mirror and there's a size icon.
All right, ladies and gents.
All right, we have one ready. Looks like blue team is ready to get this going. Hopefully gold will press the start button. Quick look at the teams here. All right, and here we go.
Game has begun.
There are three ways to win. That's the name of the game.
All right, off drop. Gold does an unusual up and down to the right there. Blue's going to take center and probably hold.
So Blue's got both speed gates at the moment as well.
This is an interesting match because the both queens are actually a married couple. So, marital counseling here.
Watch that column. Dangerous.
All right.
Dangerous. Oh, picking up. Nope.
Gold's going to wrap
queen
up and take a gate.
Blue's taking snail back. Blue's got all the gates.
Does have all the gates, yeah. Gold needs to get out and wrap gates. Probably do a little bit of a chase until a bear can get in. Or that works too. You know,
sure.
She's just gonna stay there
just
until
one at a time.
Until like one could get in.
Watch out. Oh.
Ab's just gonna have to stay up here. Oh, she went down.
Yeah. So Blue's got two warriors, Gold's got none at the moment. They're hurting for some gates. Trying to pick up right gate here.
Abs is back up again.
Queen goes
got
down.
Picked off, unfortunately.
She's still got another one left.
Blue Snail is running pretty well. Although Gold is running decent berry game. So if Gold can actually take over Snail here and hold it for a moment, they could actually turn this around pretty easily.
Gold
Queen needs to do is go in and actually take over the situation.
Yeah.
And although it's a little tricky.
Oh!
Nice
she
escape.
Got out of there.
Nice
that
kill.
Was a good escape by Leah.
Now it's just going to be stay alive and then keep that snail
clear
head.
Clear it.
Oh, wow.
That's right.
She had
the life to do it. At least stalls the snail. Gold's going
right,
to try to get
some
berries.
Leah's going to have to go right back to Snail if she wants
Blue's,
to try
Blue's
and stop this.
Close.
But she's taking a little too long and got caught, actually.
She had to try to make a
last
Hail
life.
Mary.
Yeah. You gotta go for the superhero moves right at the end, you know? I mean, you're going to lose either way, you know?
Right.
Maybe you won't lose.
That last inch.
Little bonus map here. We don't turn bonus maps up for League Knights.
Why would you?
Why would you? Yeah, exactly. In the dungeon. Although, we see a lot of cheaters on this map here. Half of blue team just flew around.
Hey, what do you want?
For those unaware, the dungeon is a mini game for the mini map or the bonus map, in which everybody dives into the middle, and you're not supposed to attack other players until you touch the floor.
Yep.
For queens, you have a slight advantage because you're gonna touch the floor faster.
Yeah.
But you're also below everybody, so as they're dropping in, you know, you're below them and trying to dive back up. So, kind of my trick is to like cut back short, you know, slightly at the very beginning, and then try to wrap up to the outside. You know, up to the outside.
But you got
to
be careful not to catch the
lip. Yeah, exactly. The small under ledges will catch you and stop you right away. I've been stuck under there quite a few times. But, you know, it's good practice staying in there, you know, and weaving and dodging.
So moving on to night map here, we got a little tiny bump in the center, but gold drone got killed.
Gold's going to wrap speed gates here and hopefully utilize them to run berries.
So gold abs has got speed and is waiting on a gate, but their queens...
All right. Gold has right gate tagged. Maintaining it. Oh.
Yeah, gold abs took way too long after they gave up on it.
That was a little, she slid out a little too far on that one, I think.
The speed warrior.
Yeah, the night map in the middle is pretty dangerous. Yeah. It's kind of like a triangle of death, especially if you like peek out at all. Anybody can just kind of fall through and clip those corners. It's pretty risky. This is going to be tough for Gold Queen here because she's got a lot of hive guarders, so her berry run, where she only needs five, is going to be heavily hindered by that.
Blue's down to one berry, and the queen just got killed.
Yeah. Abs is going to have to try and be like a godlike character.
Go for it. Oh!
Took the military one again.
Yeah. She's playing a strong military team here. A lot of the players on the blue team have been heavy warriors for a long time. So,
Lisa, this is the first set. So
yeah, this is going to be game three of set one.
Right.
Hi, Lisa. All right, game three. Here we go.
What are we going to see?
We're going to see a kind of traditional opening here, wrapping the safe gate.
Blue went opposite speed.
Looks like gold is going to hopefully try and ladder up some warriors. Blue queen is being kind of pesky over here on the right, though. Gold queen needs to tag some more gates.
So blue is trying to keep control of gold gates. Try to slow them down.
Gold has two gates now, that's good. Although blue's gonna take
gold's
that
only got one
out.
Warrior, and now they have none.
Oh, they have one coming out right. Skulls is gonna come out right. We'll see how she does.
That's
Anita. Alright, blue's already got quite a few, over halfway done on the pop tires. So,
one of those gold warriors just got taken out. Now the second one did too. So, blue's going berries.
Oh, one got kicked in for gold. Gold needs to get some warriors up here in hive guard. It's really what the only thing they can do, and unfortunately they don't have the gates to do.
Only
so
one blue berry runner.
Center gate is still open, so possibly they can turn this around.
Blue's going to take this with one berry runner.
Abs is kind of having to solo this hive guard. Oh, and Abs kills the queen there and continues the hive guard. This is some power moves by gold Abs here. Adriana.
Not enough.
Blue got the last berry and that's it.
Woo! There's a berry in here. No blue.
Good try by the Mighty Morphin Power Drones. So we can show the win counters here for a second. They kind of look odd at the moment, but yeah.
And we are changing.
Well, I think we can change this to a best of five. There we go. Show win counters. That's a little better.
You can fill up all
the next teams are going to be the Breakfast Club.
The Bee Breakfast Club.
And the Bee Breakfast Club.
And the Kimbe.
The Kimbe.
The Queen Bay.
The Queen Bay Matumbo.
the Queen Bee Matumbo.
With five other names that I will not try to wrap up.
I'm going to switch out for a set while I eat my salad so I don't eat in front of everybody.
Do it.
I got your boot.
Get on up here.
Let's go. Richard, how the hell are you?
Hey, right. Like, can I, like, can I borrow your beard a little bit? Like,
sure.
You cut off the ash.
Are we? We can four-man this.
We can four-man.
Come on, Marcelo.
Let's do it.
Corner over here.
Are you in the camera?
I'm gonna be the cool guy who sits in the chair backwards.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, yeah, watch out for that guy.
Cool guy from the 90s.
So is this live and that's not live?
Yes.
Yeah, right side's live.
Richard can do this.
This camera's perfect for me. There you go.
Richard knows what the hell he's doing. Hey, how's it going in Twitch land?
All right, we got some good teams coming up in the plate here.
Yeah, this just is gonna show be a really real quick. Good slate here. We've got blue team's gonna be the Bee Breakfast Club, and gold we got the Queen Bee Mutumbo.
You still got the card?
It should be up there.
It's actually for
Ryan. Me. Did you take the card?
I
How the hell did he get it?
I don't know.
Who?
Aiden?
Wait, yeah, I don't know. I don't know where the card is.
I'm assuming they got it.
Well,
yeah, they put in grids, yeah.
I guess Phil had it?
What?
Other Phil had it?
No, other Phil.
Probably, I'm right here. Alright, yeah.
As long as some random asshole didn't just walk over and swipe it off the cab.
You're gonna want to look at the camera the whole time.
I mean,
whatever. Click transition. There you go.
Here we go.
I really
that's good at all.
I'm now here looking this way. Because, like, otherwise I look this way.
So it's, everyone's tiny.
We got a stereo view of Josh.
You can look over here.
And
you
get to his
Phil.
Camera one, camera two. Camera one, camera two.
Blue Queen's Joe. Wow, it's like it's brother
Marcelo
versus
gets
who's Anthony?
Right,
who's Anthony?
Yeah, that's totally Wayne's
way. It's totally brother versus brother.
All right, what's happening in the game, though, guys?
You know, there's some queens,
so
there's some berries.
Brother, Civil War shit.
There's some kind of snail.
Dearest Annabelle. We have been forced into a new
there's
formation.
There's some pink circles. One just got carried into the gold circles.
So someone has been rocking the touch tunes and playing all horrific metal music for the last hour. And it's been very difficult for me personally.
Well, just throw some Billy Joel on there.
I would rather have Billy Joel.
Define horrific.
Somebody go
talk to Claire. We're metal fans.
No, but no, this is like, but like, it's not appropriate to have like 30 minutes of like crabcore.
It was not me. Hey, Lisa, if you pick a song, we'll play it on the touch tunes, by the way. You call it out.
Yeah.
It's your choice. Hey, we're taking requests, everybody.
But you must donate this.
If we had that set up, that would be such a good idea. Shit.
We'll be the first scene to fucking do that.
We'll recommend that to
yes.
You know, like, we'll wait on the touch
tunes. Make a donation, and then we'll play a game.
Half of it goes to extra life.
It's like gold's getting a decent barrier run situation. After a
shit. Jonathan's queening on gold right now.
He seems to be playing a little bit safer tonight than normal.
That was a good one.
That was a good in and out by Joe.
It looks like gold's got half berries spilled.
So as a reminder to those of you not ATX, this team matchup is the brothers Pollard again.
Oh, good point.
Yeah, this is
two queens are Joe and Jonathan.
You know what, Marcelo's joke makes a lot more sense now. I kind of missed
the,
I did not pick that one up. No, the fact that it's brother versus brother.
Oh, yeah.
Something like that.
No, but then I went with the full Civil War.
Yeah, he went Civil War.
And then I did the letter, like, my dearest Annabelle, I pray that one day we'll be able to resolve all differences. Carly Rae Jepsen?
Josh doesn't like
all right,
do you
so,
want, wait, do you want Call Me Maybe, or do you want Part of Your World, her cover of the Little Mermaid classic? Or perhaps some other Carly Rae.
He knows way too much Carly Rae Jepsen.
I teach middle school.
All right.
All right, so it looks like we're going berries.
Gold's got four berries left now.
I just want to say, Gold Stripes, good job on the reverse ledge guard.
Not much action from Snail.
Blue's got some good snail progress.
Blue's starting to pull Snail right now.
Open hive. Gold's got an open hive. Can they make it? Oh, they didn't make it. It's not open. As long as that queen is up there guarding berries, that's a problem for Blue. Like, because that queen is much more versatile elsewhere.
Yep.
All right, so we're going to play some Call Me Maybe.
Do it.
Gold control gates. Oh. Yep. Gold just cleared the hive.
Yeah, and now we got the open hive and three berries left.
Yeah, Blue
is going the wrong way.
Blue really needs to figure out what they want to do here. Yeah. One of those things should be to stop dying.
They've got Wayne, they've got, this is a classic Blue, this is a classic Blue Day Map special right here.
I'm surprised that Blue is doing as poorly as they are.
I'm not, this is classic Joe Pollard's and Wayne Park's Wudu special.
Can we call it?
What does that mean?
Like, so you're losing?
Can we call it?
Wait, like, what do you mean?
Hang on. Can we call it Kill Me Maybe?
Oh my god.
Team name.
No, we've already call got me maybe. Team name.
Oh, Kill Me right. Maybe.
Oh. I think you should have, I honestly think that, so that having more than one pint is too much. You should have both. Oh, nice. Here comes the last berry.
Boom! Yeah, I think you're right, Josh. Blue was all over the map. They couldn't quite pick a strategy.
See, I think that you shouldn't have more than one pun in a team name. One pun. Kill Me Maybe, that's too many things.
How many puns can you fit into a team name? Whatever that maximum is, that's what I want on my team.
Queen bee, very high queen.
The queen bee Mutombo, whatever the mumbo jumbo.
Yeah, they have a pretty good idea of what's going on.
So I could be having an entire paragraph.
Unfortunately, it looks like for the queen bee Mutombo, the other team is in their house.
Yes.
They just lost the. Yeah.
Well done, sir.
Unfortunately, yes.
So Lisa, Call Me Maybe is two songs away. If you hang around, tune in a little bit, you'll be able to hear it in the background.
Can we do like the lip sync like they used to do on the YouTubes? Where they call me maybe?
You call it the YouTubes?
Yeah.
Yeah, the YouTubes.
Can we do like, but like we do the lip sync so like we're here, like you know how they used to do lip sync things for Call Me Maybe? That was a thing. Middle school, that I got my finger on the pulse of Teen America. Sadly.
Alright.
Yeah, let's do it.
What is this?
This is called Night Map.
Oh, there's a game.
There's a game going on. Queen just wiped two drums.
They all went middle and they didn't see Blue Queen go.
Yep. Queen came across instead of over. Good clear on center. Oh! Watch out.
Hey, Joe knows what he's doing.
Watch out.
I'm very surprised at the lack of berries that are happening right now, though, especially on Day Map.
That sucks for berries.
I mean, it doesn't suck.
I prefer Day Map.
It's viable.
I'm gonna be real. My hot take is I'm going to prefer Day Map even though it's less viable. Because Night Map is a pain because the hive is enclosed and it's just like there's only one point of entry.
I feel like that makes it better.
You can drop the entire game.
Each day you've got that little ledge, you can go up or down and juke a little bit, but with night it's like, you can only come in from the...
No, I feel like there's more opportunity to juke here than on day.
Big time. Yeah, day you can shut that down in one position.
Yeah, easy.
Easy.
It's much harder to high guard on.
Snail. Here we go. Oh, there. I think Snail's got it.
Uh-oh. We won't get a family portrait because we got a blue stripes taking one for the team. Oh, that was a wipe and a half.
No, that other high guard is still there.
Yeah, high guard is over.
Here it goes.
That is surprisingly easy on the.
All right, listen.
Did you do this?
This is Lisa's fault.
That's lip sync. You don't need the mic.
Wait, cut to Britney's dancing.
How do I get?
Do it again.
I can't escape the fucking cameras, man.
You're surrounded by cameras.
Yeah, you are.
I want out of here.
Why? Cut away from Marcella's dancing.
Can we zoom in on Marcella's dancing action?
Oh yeah, I'll zoom myself in.
There you go. It's like I got this.
Amazing. Can you actually hear it through the microphone though?
I'm not lip syncing. Right, I know, but.
Alright. Tell all the Pinballz you're welcome.
Everybody left, actually. There's no more people here. They're all gone.
It's only Killer Queen people.
Yep.
Dusk. Oh, gold checks missed that top center jump.
Let's call him out a little bit, Richard. Hey, it'll make him feel better whenever they review the footage.
I'll just call it in how I see it. Oh! Good escape, my gold queen.
Yeah. Jonathan's getting a little frisky here. Yeah. This is a bad position, but he...
Oh, man!
So debated.
So...
Jonathan is, he's one of the spicier queens here in Austin, though. Right, if you watch long enough, you'll see.
Yeah. Look at that. Like, Blue Queen was right there. He just still went straight into the snail.
Yeah. Hey, so Gold does have a very good strategy going on right now. They're going to 2-2 with the berries.
Yep.
Jonathan's kind of being all debatey. We're done with whatever that is.
He's got most of the gates at the moment, too. While they've already got tops on Gold.
This is what Jonathan wants. Basically, he's attracted a lot of attention while his berry runners can do whatever they need.
Yep.
Looks like someone adds a grab and speed. That would be Brittany Coleman. Yeah, the one ledge. Oh, yeah, the wood chipper down there with blue abs.
I'm not sure what she was trying to do there. Oh, she's trying to get a berry. She should have gotten it from the top center.
Yeah, there was another position. She should have just platformed up, probably. However, I mean, that's a lesson.
Especially with speed, that top jump is way easy.
Well, she's one of our newer players. Sure. Great job. All around. Good job, Jonathan, and then good job, Blue Checks.
What'd I miss?
That's Wayne.
Wayne just killed people. It was good.
Wayne!
Must be Monday.
Hi, Wayne.
Hey, Friday. Well, so Gold has all top berries.
Yeah,
that's pretty fun.
Where are they going?
Britain's abs, right?
Get in there.
Is it 1-1?
Get in there.
She is abs. Gold abs.
Get in there.
I'm like out of breath.
Actually,
yeah. Because lip syncing and dancing?
Oh, yeah.
We just had a workout.
Hannah and I met swing dancing. That was
good. Yeah, it's 1-1. Sorry.
Hey!
Well, it looks like Queen's on last life on Gold, but they got two berries
left. Two berries.
Stay alive.
Last life. What's gonna give?
Oh! Blue is also on last life here.
Get it! Get it! Get that! Oh!
There's one.
Get it!
Oh!
Oh! Get it!
He wouldn't have made it anyway because the guy was coming out.
This blue checks. Clutch. Oh, here it is from the top. Oh! No. All right, blue checks is down.
Oh, got that sick bump.
They got the bears. Whoa. The bears above it, and that. All right, they got that stuff coming back now.
They got a bounce bear.
Man, that bounce bear is making life difficult for that.
If I'm Jonathan, I'm trying to kick a berry into the hive right now. Yep. He's, like, there's two berries hanging out on the top.
Here comes.
Oh! They got it. Stay alive. 2-1. 2-1.
Are we up next?
That goes to Be Breakfast Club.
Yeah, we're next.
Yeah, mate. We are next. This is Mike Marcello.
All right, you guys.
Happy to do it, Lisa. For you. All right, now watch us lose.
I don't want to.
We're blue.
I can't wait till he dies. Lisa's in the chat.
I went pretty well.
Yeah. Just go up there and be like, as soon as he watched me, like,
it's like working on that.
What up, people?
And then he managed to catch the warrior game. I got all of that. I threw off everything.
I'm going down and I'm like,
starting off a snail. With snail here. Pretty good job. Got off in time. We got double speed on blue here. Blue got one slow, two speed.
Blue's running 3-1, it looks like.
So we got Josh on blue, Queenie. Joe on gold, Queenie. Ooh. That died there off of Blue Warrior at the subway.
Yeah, they're both doing 3-1, and the goal, it's almost past the middle barrier, but oh, there we go. Blue's back on it.
Yeah, no berries run yet, which is an interesting choice.
Yeah, for me, one of the most frustrating things about Snail on Daymap is the middle becomes just an endless killing ground. If it becomes really contested in the beginning, it just goes on.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like anyone's willing to really switch up their strategy. But it looks like Blue is doubling down on making sure that they get that Snail at least out of the subway for a little bit.
Yeah, if I was Gold, I would have definitely started throwing a few berries in my own. But... Oh, that was a good feed, actually.
Yeah, you managed to dive in there between the three, like the triad. The goal of the triad is to make it to where it's basically impenetrable, and it was penetrated there.
All right, now we're going to see some fan. Oh, well. All
right, looks like Gold decided to send two drones to run some berries. We're going to see some day berries going on.
We need to get some more warriors up to start fighting or something. So.
Nice kill there by Josh. Looks like Joe's trying to lock out the military gates. Wasn't quite able to pull it off, though. Blue Warriors, he's going to have to get in there. He has no military backup, so he should probably go on a gate tagging spree and tab his team.
Yeah, game. Right when he needs them, because Gold's on last life. He's fixing to have to go into suicide mode. That is not Joe's strong point, still suicide.
He's hero moding. He's stuck hero moding. Unfortunately, in this position, when you're Gold Queen, you have to go tag gates. Even if you're going to lose, if you leave, you have to go try. Because you're going to lose anyway.
Yeah, and Gold...
It's just attrition at this point.
Yeah, and Gold isn't getting those berries up fast enough.
Yeah, and they still got half the berries left, which is a tough spot.
Yeah, pretty much impossible. Oh, here we go. Oh!
Almost. Really good move there. Didn't quite get the J-hook on the way back.
Yeah, that was a lot of... Blue had some good Snail defense. They hovered in the right areas to keep good coverage. Yeah, good stuff.
A little bonus game action.
I don't know the name. I don't get the reference. I'm just offended by it, by their taking our idea.
Right. Sure.
Who's? Okay, whatever. I did mean to look it up and see who those people were, but I do not know who they are.
They are. He's just a sports figure. Yeah.
Yeah.
Basketball.
You know, you can commentate too. Yeah. You may. You could and may.
Yeah.
Did you? As Brittany, a future commentator, apparently has great skill in the field.
Yeah, she says she's actually the best commentator, and she's surprised that we don't let her commentate anymore.
Yeah, I know, and she went out to smoke. She's going to ruin her perfect commentating voice. Just no perspective, that one. Throwing it all away. Alright, so let's see. Looks like there's going to be a fight for the center. Oh!
The ledge.
Oh, wow.
Cost him a life. Yeah. Tough one there, Josh. Joe's able to capitalize.
Well, and there was a beat where Joe almost didn't do it. He had him twice. And he actually had enough time to still get him. Because he was going it, but he didn't want to dive, and they did it anyway. Still got him. Good stuff.
I'm surprised Gold Queen didn't go for the early military lockout. Definitely could have. It cost her two extra Blue Warriors. Although, oh man, tough day J-dive there, Josh. Again, gonna get another Blue Warrior out because Gold Queen's not locking down that other gate. Very surprised.
Yeah, when there's still coverage, yeah, that should be the next objective. Hovering in a zone you control with support is not, that's not a Queen activity. Countdown to goodness.
Windows just decided it wanted to update.
Yeah, and 9/11 for some reason. Not a conspiracy.
No, on Nightmap, Zero Berry's run, Military Victory, great job, gold team. Josh, it looks like Josh had a hard time there.
Yeah.
His Warriors kept going down.
He was a little off. He was off early. You know, it's one of those things we play.
Yeah, so we're tied up on this set. This one's going to take it. The sets don't particularly matter, but still, if you're keeping track, it's going to go down on this go here. Looks like we have a standard military kit opening here for the upper wrap. Gold went straight to snail. Blue went straight to double top berries. Looks like they're going to get quadruple top berries, more than likely. Yeah, they did.
Gold immediately started guarding the snail. So,
gold is trucking along on that snail. It's tough. Blue's got top berries all the way up. They're down to six bottom berries. That snail is trucking.
Yeah, Blue has all top berries, so they're four away.
I'm going to guess this drone here is going to switch off with bottom snail. No, they're not. Oh, he's going to go back. We got speed. Speed got snail him. Rolling.
I don't know why the...
Great positioning there by Blue Queen. Josh Bird.
Two away. They're unopposed, so it looks like Blue won.
Oh,
Blue
Blue's got it.
Yeah.
Man, that was some fast baron running, guys.
That was.
Great job. Great job, guys.
And, Blue kept a lot of their warriors guarding their hive, and I was thinking that was a mistake, and they rushed over there and they still had it. So I was wondering why they had to put more push on the snail, but they made the right move.
So we have Forsman and Associates, and, again, Drone Star Beard. Drone Star Beard on gold! Four Horsemen and Associate on blue. How's it going, Adriana?
That's good. I got my pizza and I got my beer and I'm playing Killer Queen. So it's good.
Sounds like a good day, yeah.
Yeah. How about you? How are you doing?
Doing alright.
So, did we figure out what the four horsemen actually means here?
I think it's all reverse centaur and weird haircuts on Brian Lucas, as far as I can tell.
Okay. Glad that was taken care of. There was some confusion. Could have been a last name. Could have been that they ride horses. I don't know. There's so many different ways to interpret that. Did they start out with needing a sub? Like they're only a four-person team? Is that where the silhouette comes
from? Yeah, so my team, B-Rect Fast Club, and Four Horsemen Associates all have one sub every week standard. Which is interesting because we have like eight subs and they pretty much all show up. So they could have just like played. But you know, that's okay.
Just the register, do you mean?
Right, yeah.
Sure, yeah. Well, maybe they need to get their feet wet and we'll see them commit next month. Probably.
Yeah, I mean, we're always glad to welcome them next month.
Okay, so Josh Bird just played on blue, now he's on gold.
Yeah, he's switching over to gold, he's waving at us. Hi, Josh.
And
hi, Josh.
Yeah. We got Brian playing green on blue.
And here we go. Looks like we got a slow warrior opening on blue. Skulls must have missed his speed jumps on orange. They already got two warriors out. One of them is... Are they all slow?
Everyone going military. Kind of seems like it.
Full military with the snail. Gold has snail advantage at the moment. Here comes out Subway.
Oh,
great kill by Blue Queen there.
Get a queen kill there.
Gold's got both speed gates right now, so Blue's going to be forced to do slow warrior, slow snail, basically everything once they die. But I guess Blue tagged one in speed gates.
So pretty much a snail game.
Yeah, Blue managed to run one berry.
That was a kick in.
Oh, was it a kick in?
It wasn't a purposeful berry.
So we got one accidental berry on Blue, no berries on Gold.
It's a snail game.
Great
and
kill there by Brian.
First queen kill.
Brian looks like he's on a pretty good course to locking out all the gates here. Oh, got bumped.
And, yep, that was a nice assist there by Goldass. And good call on Gold Queen's part, ducking out of there. There was a pinch getting set up there.
Oh, watch those ledge jumps, though. Got caught a couple times.
Oh, tight spot.
So yeah, Gold's totally locked out right now, which is a great position for Blue Queen.
Oh
man.
And
gotta,
that turn back. Okay.
Probably pulled down on the stick just a little bit there in his excitement.
And Blue Queen's on last life here. Blue is definitely up on Warriors, so.
Yeah, Gold would have tied him there, but I think Skulls went down and inopportune at the moment. Gold's trying to push it back, and Brian is on last life, so he's got to kind of like stay out of there. He really should get some military up so that he doesn't have to take all the risks here. It's going to happen.
Oh.
Yeah, it's tough.
Dude, on me, all my previous Nintendo consoles have basically been Smash Bros. Like, that was the main game I wanted. I have a feeling
got some excessive, I believe, is how we define celebrating on Gold's side. Not cool, guys.
Yeah. I mean, they haven't
lost. We're all just trying to have fun, guys.
I know, they're a pretty tough team. I would have been pretty happy, too. I would have had some excessive celebrating, I think.
Okay, with, like, give it a woo or something along those lines?
No, that's Joe's thing.
Oh, right.
I don't want to, like, do Joe's thing. I have my own thing.
Okay.
The Adriana celebration.
Celebration.
Yeah.
Dance? Is it a dance?
Sometimes.
And here we go. Gold's locked out of, or locked Blue out of speed gates here, and they got one warrior gate. Oh, man. Little upside down flying. It's Chris's signature move here. Interesting, Brian's over there trying to stop the berry rush. He had two warriors out, lost one though. Yeah, he's got to dive out of that.
Oh,
oh man,
unfortunate
great
dive
juke.
There on
great
part.
Juke. No snail pressure yet. Gold's up on berries though.
It's looking like a berry game. No one's doing much hive guarding though.
Looks like Blue Skulls is going to go down there and do a little hive garden. He's going to have to take it from Gold Skulls there, who is a speed warrior. Is Blue Skull speed? Looks kind of like it.
Yes.
Nice juke, Av. You just got slightly bumped out there at the end. Looks like Josh is going to try to assist the team there for a second on the high.
Three berries left on Gold.
Three left on Blue, on two left on Gold. Josh, where are you at, buddy? You got no warriors. Blue's got one warrior in his spot.
There it is. Great,
great rush there, Gold. Little bonus map action.
Yeah.
Alright, nice kill, buddy.
Great showing off. Oh, for real? Who played this?
Who do you think it was? You know it's Anita.
Okay. How suspect she was right now.
She's a riot. She's grabbing Brandon's butt with the grabbers that we got to replace the ones we lost on the tubing.
Well, they are meant to grab trash.
And butts. Works pretty well.
I guess it depends on the, like, globeness of it, right?
Well, it's like, it's one sheet. It's the perfect size. It's like they were meant to grab butts. Okay. Oh, Barry Blitz
on
gold.
Are we tied up?
I don't remember. Hey, who won the last game? Yeah, I don't pay attention to that.
Oh, no. Oh, top Barry's on gold. Oh man, those berries are going in so fast. This is not looking good for
Blue. Huge berry rush. They do have a slow snail push on Blue's side, but it's probably not going to be good enough. Dash is doing a great job not dying here.
Yeah.
SFD is kind of the motto for gold team. Now, to be fair, that snail is trucking. It's trucking along. It might make it. It might make it.
Yeah, there's some definite
Josh
pressure
gotta go.
There.
Gotta go.
Ooh. Oh. Wow, it worked. I really thought those berries progressed the game so quickly. People got it sloppy and paid for it.
There
wasn't
much
to do, though. I mean, snail was running into home base there.
They had such a hard push on those berries, too, you would have suspected.
Yeah. Who's
that
next?
We got Mighty Morphin Power Drones.
That's me.
Mighty Morphin Power Drones on gold!
Root for us, we're the underdogs.
D Queen Beam Mutombo on blue.
I'm a little worried when I have someone that's like, alright, I'm gonna jump in some like fucking sword, but without vanilla,
what's up, man?
What's up, buddy?
I missed you.
I miss you too, Dr.
For like the 10 minutes that we were away from each other.
Way to take that set, by the way. It's great job.
That was my team, man. Those guys played really well. A lot of good communication going on, and then a lot of really dumb shit happening by me.
I was going to skip over that.
Not good.
Yeah. What was your favorite dumb moment?
It wasn't on this set, but the set previously on Nightmap, where I just died over and over and over again for no reason, that was my favorite moment.
Oh man, it's best when there's no reason.
Yeah. Yeah, and literally none. Zero. It was zero.
Alright.
So we got Mighty Morphin Power Drones and the Queen Bay Mutombo, right?
Alright, yeah. The Queen Bay Mutombo with Joe. We got Davey, Richard, Phil and Wayne, and then on the all-girls team, we've got Adriana, queened by Leah.
Eric Garcia, Anita Peterson, and Hannah Tisson.
Hannah Tisson!
So, and then we also have Anita yelling and screaming. Standard affair.
Gold's locked out of speed gates. It's basically the worst thing that could happen to you in this game other than losing. Being locked out of speed gates.
Is it though?
It is, yeah, absolutely.
Even on day map?
Yeah, I guess so.
Right.
I mean, here we are.
It doesn't feel good. I'm not even playing and it doesn't feel good.
Yeah, it feels bad. Like, I want to go Speed Warrior. Like, I want to go kick someone off the cab right now in Speed Warrior. But
it's against the rules.
Right, I'm not allowed to. And even if I wanted to break the rules, I wouldn't be able to because we were locked out.
Right, and I say a rule, it's actually against the law. Like,
are you not allowed to physically assault someone?
No. Not here at Pinballz. At Brass Tap, you can. So join us on Wednesday nights at Brass Tap where you can physically assault people on the cab.
It's really fun. That's really the best reason to go.
And it's free. And sponsored by Joe Pollard assaulting people. There we go. He's gonna be so mad when he listens to it.
Oh yeah.
I can't be happy.
But we brought up Brass Tap. Right, yeah, Brass Tap.
He's gonna listen to this. I'm sorry, Joe, I love you. Oh man, Blue's done a really, really good job of controlling Warriors this game, and it paid off. It really paid off.
That's a tough one there.
Yeah,
it really is.
It's happened a couple times now, but it seems like if you try to keep Adriana down, it makes it a lot easier to tackle that team over there that's on gold. Right?
Yeah, I mean, Adriana's going to be a really tough Speed Warrior and probably the most veteran player on that team at the moment.
Hey, wait!
No! Followed closely by Hana and Nita. But...
Feels so good. I'm sorry. somebody said it. Alright, so Gold has opted for Speed Gambit without the Gambit. The Speed?
Yeah, Speed Gambit without actually sending anyone over. I mean, it's somewhat effective, right? It stops the other team from getting Speed. Right?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah. But, you know, that gave them a little bit of a snail push here at the beginning.
It could pay off, though. Adriana is now up. Looks like she's Speed Warrior. She just needs to wreak havoc. Yep, she's already started. Good kill by Adriana on that Blue Skulls. Oh man. So Leah's already down to last life. Snail is struck, and Jonathan, what are you drinking tonight?
I'm drinking a double dip whiskey diet, but instead of diet, it's actually Lone Star beer. Mixed with whiskey. It's great, you should try it. I know it sounds kind of gross, but
I mean, are you joking right now, or is this because of our sponsors, which are Lone Star Beer? Thank you very much.
Yeah, Lone Star Beer and Lone Star Light, which is also a beer, but they don't say the beer part for that one. They're focusing on the light. In case you're watching,
aren't people going to get confused with like electricity and electrical equipment and stuff if all you say is Lone Star Light?
Oh yeah, I mean, I guess so. I mean, it is electrifying, huh? Yeah, it's all the buzz.
You're so punny. You're so punny. Oh my god. Lisa says that someone should be in Leah's ear. Right as that happens, Leah gets a kill. Lisa, keep talking about Leah. Seems
yeah,
to
you're
help
giving
out.
Her the chatter buff. Right, chatter buff.
Chatter buff. Yeah, it's
yeah,
a thing.
I like it.
Yeah, Leah's also looking for group now.
So if you chat about Leah and we talk about Joe while the game's going on, it's like a double negative for Blue Team. Here.
So it's like commentator's curse and spectator's curse combined.
Right.
Like, but they nullify. We should have stopped talking.
Yeah, we should have stopped talking. So we got distracted. That's really our fault.
That was a good map. Good map. Damn right, Anita gives the bow. She played very well that map. Anita has some very clutch kills.
Very well.
Joe played awful. He's an awful person and an awful queen. So. That's for you, Joe. When you listen to this. But I'll see you on Wednesday at Brass Tap. I love you.
This is our fault. You obviously stopped chatting about Leah.
Yeah, wait a second. We got baited. Yeah. We got baited.
Looks like we're gonna have a little blue dunk over here, the true dunk.
Oh,
sorry, South Florida.
And they only got two. They got two of the tops. It's really tough to do the four-player top dunk. Unless you're on fire, like, or your shoes are lit up.
Right.
If you made three consecutive dunks in a row.
Got pumps and stuff and air pumps. I've tried to tell people that based off of your position on the cab,
right?
That's how it should
happen. That's the Barry hole you should go for, right? And if that was standard, then it would never be a problem again.
Jonathan, that is some next level shit.
Yeah, I feel like everyone needs to know about that, but they don't.
I only am able to bring this next level stuff to the gameplay because of inspiring players like yourself, John.
Oh, well, Jonathan. Jonathan.
Don't be embarrassed.
I'm a little
It's totally deserved. Totally deserved.
You know what? There are so many nice things that I could say about you right now, Jonathan, and I'm going to lay them out. Let me pull out my scroll here.
Sometimes your problems are your own fault.
Yeah. Number one.
Oh, all right, Blue's got all top berries, one bottom berry left.
This is going to be a tricky one.
Oh, come on! Oh. You got to make them!
Oh! Oh. The film review is not going to be kind later. Joe is going to yell at some people. Good kill.
Oh, what are you doing? Stop!
Oh, you guys
are Oh, that's amazing. All right, so who gets booted off the team for missing that jump twice?
I think it was Stripes, wasn't it?
Hey, who missed that? Who missed that?
Oh, Davey.
Davey.
That was Davey Rubin that missed that last berry jump.
Actually, Davey Rubin is a really good person, very good teammate. He's a champion in our hearts. He just happened to miss that hole.
Go! Lawyers on blue.
I love you guys.
Oh, it's all warm, Josh. Did you fart on the seat or what?
I didn't, but if you give me another Lone Star line.
Be Breakfast and
Lawyers. No, Be Breakfast Club and...
And Lawyers.
Oh.
Yeah, you're on gold. Yeah. All right. Wait, hot ass? Who? Who's got a hot ass? Oh, Josh, yeah. Hey, got a little.
All right.
What's up?
Ladies and gentlemen, Four Horsemen and Associate on Blue. The B-Wrecked Fast Club on goal. Kicking off the new set. Come on up.
You guest announcer?
Come on up.
Hello, internet and world.
We got Mark, ladies and gentlemen.
Welcome to the second week, if you haven't already been introduced. Queen Bee here at Pinballz in Austin, Texas. You don't know it's where you kill each other and also collect berries. Everything you ever wanted in the game,
brought to you by Lone Star
Beer. By Lone Star Beer.
And Pinballz. And Mugging Games. Thank you very much.
Ready to get started here.
Well, let's get it on!
Alright, Blue going quick on center.
Snail time for Blue.
Yeah. Didn't get a guard there quick enough, so Gold Queen took him out. Going right back for it, that's good.
Get back on it.
Alright, so pretty even. Gold actually doesn't have any warriors at the moment.
They're not, and I think they might be running
Blue's
berries.
Blue's only got one. They may be trying to run day berries, but they're getting a little blocked down low. Can't make their way up. Oh, nice move. Nice juke by Skull Stripes. So Stripes just went speed. Blue's pulling snail and guarding pretty well.
Oh, nice. Queen down.
Got a little
queen
bounce. A little bounce from Jonathan on the... A rare bounce from Jonathan on Gold Queen. Clearing the snail. Oh, that was risky. He got out of that one. All right, so, yeah, he was stuck there on the tiniest ledge in the land.
Gold's making a run to stall that snail, but it's not ineffective.
Yeah. Blue's right back on it.
Gold, by the way, only has 4 berries in their hive.
Yeah, not enough to put pressure on the snail.
Not really close to any kind of real econ victory here.
Yeah.
Oh, snail time, baby.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Oh, gold finally warriored up. They finally warriored up, so they're going to keep it clear at the moment, but they got to do something else if you're not going to ride on it. All right, they're going to ride snail and try to pull it back out. Missing the jump there. Stalling the snail for lunchtime.
And gold's making a run, bringing it back to the center.
Gold Queen is on last. Last life for Gold Queen. Blue still has all lives. We got Brian Lucas on Blue Queen.
There he goes.
Caught Jonathan trying to head towards snail.
Look at that lovely freeze frame shot of the murder that happened here.
Tasty.
Juicy.
Bonus game. Sorry, gotta be careful with it. Shake the camera with the table. Alright.
Is that me?
I think that was me.
Bonus stage, baby.
Most people don't know the real strategy to bonus map is to run berries.
It's true.
No points awarded on League Night for bonus game.
None at all.
It is not part of the criteria.
Well, personally, I felt the entire league should be decided on bonus game victories.
That would be interesting. Just have a bonus game league where it's just nothing but bonus game over and over. We need more bonus game maps, though. Maybe they'll come out with some. I hear they're working on some new maps.
That'd be cool.
So maybe we'll get some more bonus game maps.
I want a winter map.
Winter map.
You already have.
Maybe there's some slide physics.
We already have like time of day. Yeah, you can do some ice physics.
Yeah, some ice physics. Slide on the platforms.
If the dev is listening, yeah. Come on, man, ice physics level, bro.
Put like an icicle on the end.
You could probably do like most of this. You could do this stage in ice.
Yeah.
Just have two versions of it. Just have night and night ice.
Night ice sounds like something I drank in college. Alright, so both teams running at least a few berries. Gold got 4 in. Blue only got 2. Oh, Blue Queen down. And their berry runners denied by Jonathan over here. Just stop jumping. Alright. So Gold stopped running berries to run snail, so Blue's caught up now. But getting some lucky bounces, getting some quick berries in. Now they got 5. So does Gold. Snail is slightly in favor of Gold at the moment. But they don't seem to be going. They are going hard on it. Just got cleared. Blue just continuing to run one berry. So they're doing 3-1 berries at the moment. Seems to be working for them. Oh, watch that bouncing berry. Oh, it went over to the other side. I'm going to kick that back and forth.
And the queen is dead.
Ding dong.
Stabbed in the back.
Blue takes number 2. Team strategizing for dusk. Bonus game counts for all the points, says Lisa. I don't know about that. I'm gonna have to look that one up in the rulebook. What do you think? What do you think we're gonna see here on dusk? I think Blue's gonna warrior up. Maybe have a snail rider. Gold's
3-1 snail is
the
order.
A little bit of anything.
My call.
I think Blue's going 3-1 snail, I would agree. Gold, I'm not sure.
Blue's immediately on the snail.
Yeah. I think Gold wanted it.
Gold's running econ right now. Looks like at least they have 2 berry runners.
They got 3 berry runners, sir. Sort of.
Yeah, they don't have any warriors.
Yep. No warriors on gold.
Queen cornered up there.
Shouldn't have given up so quickly on that run there. Nice. Oh, no lucky bounces for you. Oh, and they did get a lucky bounce after all. Blue queen kicking that barrier.
Oh, a little bit of queen on queen here.
Gold queen is boxing her in. Gave up on that. Blue queen. Oh, gold
She could not have exposed her back there.
No. She couldn't get that speed warrior and then had to back
Either
out.
Either way, it's looking like six more for Econ Victory for gold.
Yep.
Down all the berries up top already filled in, so it's just time for mid and bottom berries in the hive. The easiest ones.
Yeah.
In case you didn't know, internet.
Blue's running some snail pressure, though. And they're keeping it clear as far as good as possible, so. Ooh. Gold Queen is trying to clear out their hive so the berry runners can do their job, and she did it. Good job, Jonathan.
Gold has to watch
out. She's
going to
try to clear
there.
The snail at the same time.
That's pretty close.
Before three Blue berries. Warrior up. Alright, Blue's got one warrior out. And the second one. Gold's trying to run snail, but Blue's got three warriors. Gold Queen keeping it clear for the moment. Oh, it's cat and mouse. Cat and mouse, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, wow. One more left for Gold.
Oh! Nice move by Jonathan. Clear that snail.
Another warrior coming over to the gold hive to try to lock this
It was
this
a suicide
contact.
Move by that drone.
There's three.
We got one berry on the gold side.
Three.
And they get
the
it.
Queen on the snail. This is a close match, ladies
it.
And gentlemen.
Oh! Blue takes the trifecta.
That was awesome. That was very good. We're up now.
Four horsemen and associate. Bye, internets.
Remember, I forgot.
The 5th of November?
Hey, now that's our beer. You're on gold.
Howdy, y'all. Who do we got? Hi, Lisa. You're always here. Thank you for watching in the chat. Let me see. I think people, wow, are they already ready to go?
Nope, not quite.
So the drama that's unfolding before us is that Josh Burke's team, Drone Star Beard, needs to sweep in order to tie Brian's team, Four Horsemen and Associate, in order to play for the game cards. So if Josh sweeps, then we have a playoff. If Josh does not sweep, then Brian wins the game. So we'll see what strats they want to go with. Okay, Gold takes the opening mid. Well, let me adjust the win counters. Okay. And let me adjust. There we go. Alright, that's better. Fade away. Pulled off against the Blue Queen. Strong berry start. Day berries for Blue. They do have one warrior up and three objective. Oh no, they have one trying to get up objective. Looks like they're trying to grab speed. A lot of different things going on. Pushing for split strat, good snail defense. The tricky thing about playing snail defense at this point and trying to push berries is that you're just spread so thin. So like that snail is just gonna, it's just a timer that snail's on, it's just gonna keep chugging. But I mean, it's my brother queening, so he can buy a lot of time. Ooh, careful. right around the snail. A lot of gold right around the snail right now. They're going to need to rebuild or push or do a clear, something different. Camping out. All right, good pushback. Oh! Good rap on Josh Bird's part to see that as it was evolving. So it's one win for Drone Star.
Hey, Jonathan!
Oh, that's
fine, dude. Oh,
I'm not taking it, don't worry.
Jonathan! A little encouraging exchange between Phil and my brother there.
Sandwich better show up.
Sorry, dude. No, I'm not trying to get in between.
Alrighty. Opening for mid. Looks like gold dove for the safe gate first. And we have a berry blitz. Look at those four berries going. So Blue's going to be playing on the back foot almost the entire time down here. One, trying to get warriors up. And then two, I'm trying to play berry defense. And they're going to get six berries in. This is the beauty of a blitz when it's unexpected, is that you blink once and you're basically halfway done. There's no boxer on the snail. This is basically... Oh, Miss J. That can be punished now that if they can get a warrior gate tag. They're definitely pushing snail
correctly. Jonathan's going to win. I reminded him that he was number one.
Okay. Yep. Yes. Perfect. Good telegraphing there. They have, what, five berries to go on gold. Snail is about halfway to the waterfall, maybe a little more. John's going to need to do hero mode. Oh, the kicks. John's going to need to be hero mode queen ledge guard here. But Josh Bird is on last life. So this gets interesting because Josh is going to need to take some risks. There's only two berries left now. And we have Brandon as the speed warrior, being the snail escort, and they're running a split strat with berries. So if John's banking on the fact that he himself can
only
defend,
he can do
right,
it.
Right. Which is, oh, come on, you let him through. Come on. All right, there's one to go.
They got to balls out, take that shot. Like, they got too many guys on defense right now.
Right.
Like they're either gonna get past you, or you need to kill that guy before that guy gets past you, man.
Oh, that was... Whoa!
I told you.
Phil called it.
We told you.
I said it on the stream when he did it. That was it. Pipe set. Great win. I'm sure we redlined everything audio on the audio there. So, great job on Blue. So what that means, effectively... is that Brian wins the week now because of that loss. So congratulations to Four Horsemen and Associates again for winning the week. As I'm pointing to Brian. So what's that? 1-1. Show the win counters. Transition back. All right, cool. What adjustments do we want to make? That was really a flawless opening on gold in terms of the berry blitz, but they still didn't quite get it because of how exposed he was on the military side. So we're probably going to pick for a more conservative opening on gold's side. Blue will probably run the same variation of one warrior with three objective runners, is what I would guess. Okay, what do we got? No fancy blitzes. We do have top berries being pushed, kind of. And we have all gold warriors and one snail runner. So we got a 3-1 on gold out. We got a 1-3 or 1. Actually, we got a 4-0. I think we're trying to get a speed warrior up is the thought. Great queen kill initially and great snail defense. Josh's going to tag near and not quite materialize for the next kill. John's going to get... don't get greedy on that snail defense. You'll have time. Okay, tagging near. Going to need to make more progress on those top berries in order for this to be an actual issue, because they're basically defending the top almost entirely on Blue. Blue Queen drops a life, defending the snail. We're going to need to get some military support up. We're going to need to get some gates tagged on Blue just to get some pushback. Because otherwise, you're just going to continually lose the snail when you regain control temporarily. So they need to get at least one warrior up. In order to help out. Ooh, dangerous pincer there, and he's trapped in the box. He's got to make a play. Oh, walking queen. All right, last queen's on last. They have four berries to go. They have one top berry to go. The snail is under the speed gate, and we're going to need to see some hero mode plays in order for this to work. That's part of it right there. We need to get a rider in place, even the speed rider. Whoever checks was that had... Okay, they need one more berry. This is going to get... Okay, this got super urgent on blue side. Really, oh, look out. Okay, and, oh, almost. Straight jump in. Come on, straight jump, straight. It's just a straight, oh, wide open. Let's go. Woo! Great job, Blue. Great win, great adjustments. One to win on berries on Dusk, and then two to win on military. He just needed a little encouragement from Phil, and that's all she wrote. So just needed to be reminded who he was and where he stood. Great matches, great teams, great wins all around. So as we stated before, Four Horsemen and Associate win the week. Congrats all, thanks. I think that's all the matches we have. Check the spreadsheet we have posted to check the standings. We have one more week of round robin play, and then 2 weeks from now we have the double elimination tournament that's for all the marbles, which is, yes, we are. And I'll jump on with the, I think we'll get set team Bumble Bash play going on now. So let's switch to that, and that way we can see a little bit of everything. All right, we'll see y'all on the cab.
Come on, we have a new coach. Hey, Four Horsemen. And an associate. Whoever the associate is. How much is it for?
$1.
Congratulations, guys.
Love you guys, but I'm muting this microphone. You don't need to hear this.
Thank you. Woo! Woo! You
What's up, y'all? Anybody still in the chat? Say something. Let me know. Obviously, league's over, so these are all just casual sets. Oh, great win by Blue. Brian. Yep. Oh. Okay. Howdy, howdy.
Hello.
Hello. Let's see if we can legit commentate if anybody else is on the chat. Where did our intrepid commentators go? We are back. Let's see. Warning. Oh, that was for me when I was yelling earlier. Against your, with your team that won the night map and the dust map after dropping the day map. So those are some really hype sets.
Yeah.
Those are some good adjustments. I think Donnie was a good addition to your team. It just added a quite a bit of stability to the team, having another basically flex the vanilla warrior. And then you guys could kind of do your thing. So that was definitely good. Hi, Troxer. How's it going?
Hi, Troxer.
All right.
Sorry.
All right, let's see. What do we got? Blue takes mid. Gold didn't have really an opening in a plan, so they are essentially locked out now right off the bat. Gold is pushing berries early, but it's a lot of blue right now.
Yeah, blue has their second bird there. Oh, yep. And a nice bounce into blue. Wow.
Right, yep. Okay, so the correct counter at this point is to push snail and then also to push objectives until you can get a gate up on the gold side. So they're trying to do the... I see what's up. Oh, okay. Yep, it's going to be hard. He's got basically just following instructions as he's barked orders. But we'll see. Blue is basically halfway done with berries. Snail is in the middle, still in the tug-of-war range, so there's not much left.
Blue is pushing that berry really hard.
You can call... Oh, Miss J.
Damn.
Someone got greedy. Let's go, Brian! Sorry, he knows that he missed that J, and I wanted to remind him that he missed the J so he doesn't miss J's in the future.
Oh, man.
Oh, look out.
Blue
he's running,
really
he's running, he's running.
Heavy military. Wow.
So this could go one of two ways. It'll either be a gold military loss or it'll be a blue berry win. I don't think we're going to have any snail progress either way.
Like
there we go.
Yep.
Okay. Let's take this moment to thank our sponsor, the Lone Star Beer, the national beer of Texas. And Brittany, this is your first month in league. What's your experience been like so far? I mean, really, this is your first, essentially, month in the whole Killer Queen culture. So,
right.
And you've also come to the Brass Tap, and so there's sort of a different dynamic there versus here, and just all the people here. How were you originally introduced to Killer Queen?
I was introduced actually by Brian.
Yep.
Brian introduced me. I've known him for a little bit. I've only been in Austin for a little more than a month now.
Welcome to Austin.
So,
Where from? What brought you to Austin?
Just wanting to be in Austin.
Okay, great.
Honest to God, I packed my car full of stuff from Arizona, and
yep.
I just came out to Austin. So.
Well, I mean, you know, when my wife and I originally got married and we bought a house, and we thought, where do we want to sort of start a family? Like, every sign said Austin. So we're thrilled. We have three little ones, and I don't regret the move at all. We moved for here from San Antonio, so it's just a fantastic, and then starting the Killer Queen scene here, it's brought in lots of amazing people. It's been just sort of an amazing community. We're
it's
just
like a family. It's really cool.
It is.
It's really nice to be able to join something that's so family-like, especially being a complete newcomer.
Yes, and we've tried really hard to make it where it's inviting and on topic, you know, and not toxic. Because
right.
I know the gaming culture, especially on headsets with little kids, can be. But there's
right.
sort of a niceness to playing Killer Queen in person also that sort of helps. Do you have a favorite role that you've now that you've kind of been playing out here for a couple of weeks?
I've actually really enjoyed the Warrior. I know that there aren't many, at least here, there aren't too many female Warriors. And I really am enjoying learning a little bit more about it. And whenever I get that, like, Queen kill or... I've done it twice where I've actually won
it's
a
addicting.
Set by killing
it's
the
addicting.
Queen.
It's addicting.
And it definitely gets that bloodlust.
We do. We have some fantastic queens, Adriana, Who else? Leah is queening quite a bit.
Doing great,
Anita
yeah.
is secretly a very good queen. She wouldn't admit
really?
It. Yeah, there was a set that she won at the Brass Tap against Brian. Like, legit won the set against Brian.
Yeah.
So, like, she's...
That's awesome.
She definitely should queen more. And Hannah also queens, especially at South by Southwest and other places. So definitely ask them a million questions. Obviously ask anyone a million questions. I know Leah was trying to get an all-girls team for this
yeah.
set, but he kind of got blocked because the other captains knew that she was trying to do that also. And so... That's just kind of the way it worked out.
I'm excited for a girls' team, though. I think
yes.
that that'll be a really great thing to actually have a strong female team.
Yes.
To be able to push through and make it, because
I agree.
It's very difficult.
And on the national level, there are all girls' teams that travel to other
yeah.
places. I know Seattle sent one. I know that there's basically any older scene has had an all-female team travel and compete. So. I mean, I'd love to see that. I know Leah's definitely pushing for that, so we can
yeah.
kind of see, you know, what direction they might need people. Who do we gonna play? Am I hop on? I'm gonna hop on. Let's hop on. All right.
Hop on.
Thank you. What do you call a boxer on drugs? A speed warrior.
Thank you. Woo! Thank you.